Hello everyone. Welcome to the series of trainings for BMC Helix Business Workflows. This is my second video in this series. My name is Vaibhav Wadekar. I am Lead Support Architect in BMC Software. Today, I am going to talk about creating workflows and questionnaire within BMC Helix Business Workflows. Let's dive in. This training will cover below agenda. What is catalog? How the case administrator can access the catalog? What permissions needed in order to access the catalog in order to build the workflow and questionnaire? We are also going to learn how do you create the workflow with the help of Process Designer and how do you create the questionnaires that the end user will see when submitting a service request? And at the end, workflow and questionnaire that we build, how the end users will be able to see that and submit it from BMC Digital Workplace Advance. Within BMC Helix Business Workflows, if you have the permission Case Catalog Administrator, you will be able to access BMC Digital Workplace Catalog. This is the single place where the case catalog administrator can create, maintain, and track services that he or she can build for different line of business, such as HR, finance, facilities, and so on. The case catalog administrator will also be able to create the questionnaire that includes the different series of questions the end user will be presented while submitting the request. Once the case catalog administrator create the series of workflows and questionnaire, he or she can publish those services in order for end user to see those services within BMC Digital Workplace. Let us look at the overview of the catalog. Within my screen, you can see the questionnaire and workflow can be built within BMC Digital Workplace catalog. The workflow consists of the business logic with which the case will be created within BMC Helix Business Workflows. The questionnaire is the series of questions which will be presented to the end user while submitting a request, and based on the response, appropriate cases will be created within BMC Helix Business Workflows. So the end user interface is BMC Digital Workplace Advanced, where the user will see the catalog. Once the user submits the request, the workflow and question is within the BMC Digital Workplace catalog. There is a connector framework with which the cases will be created within BMC Helix Business Workflows. Now we have learned the overview of catalog. Let us understand how do you create and build this workflows and questionnaire within Digital Workplace catalog. A workflow is a business logic that you can define with the help of Process Designer available in BMC Helix Innovation Studio. Within the business logic, it determines how the service request will be processed. For example, based on the user information, whether it should use template, it should create X number of cases, all those business logic will be driven from the workflow that you have created. On my screen, you'll see a workflow example. Here you will see that based on the user responses, it will create three cases with single user service request submission. So it will save a lot of time for the end users. Instead of creating three different cases, we can define a logic within business workflows. And based on the condition, it will create the appropriate case. So in this example, the user is submitting a request for employee onboarding, and user will be presented with a series of questions, whether he need a desk, whether he need a laptop, and whether he need a cell phone. So if he chooses yes, the appropriate cases will be created. We have looked at the workflow example in earlier slide. So let us look at the workflow questionnaires, how we can build it. So in my screen, you can see that I build the workflow questionnaire, and based on the question that the user will be selected, the next question will be presented. You can define the condition-based logic, whether the user will be prompted for the next question or not. For example, if the user selects, I do not need a desk, then he will not be presented with the next question, such as desk description. You can create this questionnaire and use it with multiple services. Once the Case Catalog administrator creates the workflows and questionnaire and publishes that service, the end user will be able to see that particular service available within BMC Digital Workplace Advanced. On my screen, as you see, the employee onboarding service that we have created is available to the end users. And the end user will be presented with series of questions such as order desk, order laptop, and order phone. And based on this questions responses, appropriate cases will be created within BMC Helix business workflows. Let us look at the demo for building a workflow, submitting a case from DWP, and verify the case is created. As you can see on my screen, I logged into BMC Helix business workflows. I'm a case catalog administrator and I can see the managed catalog. Once I hit the managed catalog, I will be able to log into the digital workplace catalog. Here, you can create a series of services bundles. Let us take a look at the service I created for this demonstration. I'm opening the employee onboarding service. Within this, you can create a catalog profile. What is catalog profile? Here, you can define the logo, the employee onboarding example. If you would like to add images or a video, you can attach it over here. You can define the service description. Here in the categories, you can define the particular service belong to which category. So I selected facility services. And then here, in order to search it within the catalog, you can define a tags, for example, employee onboarding, and then you click on save. This is the catalog profile. The next is workflow. Within workflow, you can see that I attach the employee onboarding workflow and I attach employee onboarding questions. Let us look at the workflow. This is the process designer where you can create the workflow. This is the palette on the left-hand side. So I want to create a case within business workflows. So I'll be dragging this object, create ticket, on the right-hand side. Within this canvas, you can define what sort of questions we will be capturing the information. So here you can see that I added the variables, the series of questions, order desk, order laptop, order phone, laptop, which template it should be used, and the questions for the descriptions. So within create ticket, here you can see that I define the connector, I define the GUID service request ID, the requester as the login name, and the ticket template GUID. Within this field, I'm capturing which ticket template to be used. This is the summary once the case is created in business workflows. Here the logic shows us once the user submit a request and whether the question, so here you can see this is the exclusive gateway. Within exclusive gateway, if the response is order not equal to required, skip creating this case. In that case, just send a notification. Similarly, I use this exclusive gateways during three. So based on the user responses, if users say yes, then only the case will be created for desk. If the user answers yes for the laptop, then only the case will be created for the laptop and something similar. This is the workflow. Once you create a workflow, you have to give the name for your workflow. Make sure it is enabled and then hit the save button. Let us look at the employee onboarding questions. Within this, you can see I drag the questions which we created within Process Designer. Those questions will be presented over here. And here you can see that I drag the order desk and there are series of values available such as height adjustable, fixed. I added those conditions. So if it meets those conditions, then only it will provide the desk description. If the user select not required, he will not be presented with these questions. I created the DES template where I'm going to, you can see that I pre-filled the order DES template so that once the user selected it, it will automatically use the case template, which we learned how to create a case template in earlier video. Once you create this questionnaire, hit the save button. You can define a service level agreement. You can define a cost and quantity. Here you can see that I define for all these three services, the amount and then one-time fee. You can also define the order limit. Once you create this, it will be in the draft mode. And then here you can approve and publish. Now I publish this, you can create a copy of it. In the next video, we will learn how you can take this service from one environment and import it to the another environment. This is how you create the employee onboarding service and questionnaire. Once you publish the service, it will be available for end users. So I logged in on my screen to BMC Digital Workplace. Here you can see the service the case catalog administrator created is available to consume, employee onboarding. Let us go ahead and submit the request. Here you can see that I click on employee onboarding. I'll be presented with the catalog profile and the service description. Here you can define the rating review if you would like to review this product. You can add the particular item to the cart. If you would like to submit it for someone else, you can do so. You can also add it to the favorite, or you can share this URL, copy this URL and share with another user. So let us go ahead and click request now. Here you can see the question that we have defined within the questionnaire section will be presented to the end users. So here in the order desk, select, I want a height adjustable desk. You can see the based on the question response, the next question is provided. I'll order the next thing. I need a Surface Pro from Microsoft, 16 GB RAM, and I would like to have an iPhone 10, 128 GB, and silver color. And I'm completing this request. And you can click I am done. Within my activity sections, you can see that the request will be created. Request ID 509, order ID 504. If for some reason, if you'd like to track whether this has actually created the cases or not, the case catalog administrator can come to the BMC Digital Workplace catalog and go to reports, service request section. Here you can see that the user submitted this request. Here you can see the order number is 504, request ID 509. Within Digital Workplace catalog, you can see that this is the request that the end user submitted. And here you can see the view process, what exactly happened. So this user presented with this. So order desk, the case is actually created. The case number is rightly shown here. Same thing for order laptop. This is the case that has been created. And for order phone, this is the case that has been created. Let us go back to business workflows and actually verify whether these cases are created or not. So I'm just going to go back to business workflows. And here you can see that these three cases has been created with the same request ID 509, order a cell phone, order a laptop, and order a computer desk. If I click on this case, you can see that I need a height adjustable desk along with the chair. This is the question response that we have said. Now let us come to the troubleshooting section. This will help the administrator in case of some issues like unable to open the managed catalog. The administrator has to make sure that the person has case catalog administrator permission and catalog is configured appropriately within BMC Helix business workflows. Problem that case administrator will report is, hey, I've created the service, but the end user will not be able to see that service within the Digital Workplace Advanced. The case catalog administrator need to make sure when the service is published, it is published to appropriate virtual marketplace. you can create the services and make them available to certain set of users with the help of entitlements as well as virtual marketplace. In order to learn more about Catalog, how do you create the workflows and questionnaire, and how you will be able to present those services to end users, you can find all those details into the documentation links I posted on my screen. I hope you found this training useful. Thank you for your time.